Welcome to day five of our 10 days of prayer seeking revival. Today the topic is spiritual or carnal? What's the difference? Our scripture verse today is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, the last verse, which is verse 16, and the last part of that verse, which says, "But we have the mind of Christ." So here Paul is talking about the mind of Christ being the Spirit of Christ, the Holy Spirit in his life, in our lives. And today we want to consider what it means to be spiritual or carnal. I'd suggest that you actually look at reading verses 14 from chapter 2 all the way to verse 4 in chapter 3. And here Paul talks about three types of people in this world. And the first person he talks about is the natural person, which is really all those who are non-Christian, who have no spiritual inclination. In fact, they think spiritual things are foolish. And then he talks about the brethren. And the brethren here is all Christians. And unfortunately, in our church as Christians, there are carnal Christians and there are spiritual Christians. And the carnal Christians are those that are worldly Christians, that live by the world, that live by the flesh, by their own intent, and are not focused on having Christ lead their lives. The spiritual Christian is though the one who has the Spirit of Christ, the Holy Spirit, in their heart, and is connected, truly connected to Jesus. And in Revelation, the Laodicean church, which is the present-day church, is accused of being lukewarm. God wants us to be hot Christians, which are the spiritual Christians. He doesn't want us to be lukewarm. He's going to spit us out of his mouth. He can't do anything with us if we're lukewarm. Also, Jesus himself talks about, in the parable of the 10 virgins, the wise virgins and the foolish virgins. The wise virgins were those that had the oil when Christ came in the second coming. They didn't run out of the oil. And the oil is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. So today we want to focus on looking at ourselves internally. Are we carnal Christians? Are we spiritual Christians? Let's not point fingers at anyone else. Let's look at ourselves. And also, when we're praying today, I'd encourage you to pray for the church leaders, the worldwide church leaders, also the local church leaders. And those aren't just the pastors or the elders. Everyone in the church should have a position. So Sabbath school teachers, cameramen, everyone in the church has a role. We are all leaders in some way or another. What kind of leaders are we? Are we carnal leaders? Are we worldly leaders? Are we being spiritual and wise leaders? So let's just have a moment of prayer. Join me in prayer, please. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much that you are so keen on everyone in this world being saved. You came to this earth for us sinners, and each one of us is a sinner. But we just pray that each of us would look at our own hearts and be convicted as to whether we are living carnal, worldly lives or whether we are spiritual. The good news is that you care about us and that there's still hope. If we are carnal, we just pray that we would turn our hearts to you and just ask for your Holy Spirit to fill us, to guide us, to change us, to give us the mind of Christ. We just thank you so much for the leaders in our church. We just particularly pray for our local pastor, and we pray for all those other pastors and elders and everyone in the various church offices that have a role in spreading the news. We each have a role in spreading the news. We just pray that you would fill us with your Holy Spirit each day. Renew us with your Holy Spirit so that we can finish this mission that you have sent us here to do for you and through you. We just ask for your Holy Spirit again. We ask this in your name, Lord Jesus. Amen.